Hello all. Yesterday we saw two tools, Nmap and Nessus. They help in detecting the vulnerability present in the system. But to be sure of that vulnerability, we'll try to exploit that vulnerability using Metasploit. So today's demo is all about Metasploit. So let's begin with. I have two operating systems. One is the Ubuntu one, which we are using, and the other is Windows XP. This is our target system on which the vulnerability is actually present. So this operating system is Microsoft Windows XP Service Pack 1. So let's find out the IP address of this system so that we can figure out, we can attack it. So to get the IP address of Windows XP, we'll use ipconfig in the command prompt. So we'll go to the command prompt and we'll type ipconfig and we'll get the IP address of the system, which is 10.129.156.216. Similarly, we can get the IP address of our machine from which we are attacking. For that, we'll use ifconfig and so the IP address of our system is 10.129.26.60. And to be sure of that the target system is indeed live, we'll just try to ping it. So when we ping this, we'll hopefully get some reply. So we are indeed getting the reply. So that means that system is available. Now to start the Metasploit, we'll have to give the command msf console, but that we need to do in super user mode. So we'll give sudo msf console. After giving the password, this will take some time, but we are skipping time, so this will start, and once it start, it will show here that in its current database it has 1290 exploits. That means they are in total around 1300 exploits to be target, to we can target them. So to get a list of all the commands that are there, we can use help. Okay, so here is the command show exploits, which will actually load all the exploits in its database so that we can search it later. So this will load all the exploits and it will list indeed. So we can see the exploits, that there are some of the exploits like buffer overflow. So they are, I am highlighting them, some of them. So this is soft remote buffer overflow attack. It is present on Windows system. Then there is another exploit. Now yesterday we saw that on scanning this system with Nessus, we found that there is a exploit with the name MS028067. So let's indeed search that exploit, whether it is present in the Metasploit or not. It is indeed there. So this is the complete path of that exploit. So we'll try to attack our Windows system using this exploit only in this demo. So we'll just copy that exploit and we can use the command use, which will actually load that exploit and we'll work with it further. So this prompt is changed to this exploit name. So initially it was MSF, now it changed to MSF with the exploit name. We can type the command info, which will give the list, give all the information of this, about this exploit. So here is the name of the exploit. So this is regarding stack corruption and its platform is Windows. That means it is available, this exploit is only available in Windows. And this rank grade means that there is a high probability that actually we can attack this system. Also it shows the available target. So this is a list of all the operating systems along with their service pack in which this exploit is present, vulnerability is present, and our system, which is Windows XP SP1, is indeed in this list, so we can attack that. There are some options which we need to fill, which I'll tell you later. And this is a small description of this vulnerability. So it says that there is a bug in the code netapi32.dll which we exploit. So we'll give a command show options, which will tell what all options we need to fill. So here we need to give three options: rhost, rport and smb pipe. But rport and smb pipe has already been given a default setting, default value, so we'll keep that and we'll just give the value rhost, which is the target address. So we initially saw the target IP address, which is 10.129.156.216. So we'll again give that. So we'll set this ROs to the given IP address. Now to exploit any system, we need to send some piece of code to that system. So in Metasploit, one very good such code is Metapreter. So that piece of code is actually called payload. So we'll set the payload to the meta to use to we we'll instruct the Metasploit to use the payload with Windows Metapreter reverse TCP. So this will actually go into the target system using that vulnerable backdoor, and it will try to create a connection between the two systems. So also we need to give some options to this Metapreter code as well, which we can again see using show options. So here we are seeing that LHost is currently empty, and LHost is the listen address. So we need to give the IP address of our system from which we are attacking. So we already calculated that, figured out that using ifconfig. So this is 10.129.26.60. So we'll set this LHost. So now we are ready to attack. Just to be sure that all the options are filled, so we'll use show options, and that indeed all the options are filled. So we'll exploit this using exploit. And this says that Metapreter session 1 is opened. That means that exploit is indeed successful, and we have successfully entered into the target system. And there are whole lot of commands in Metapreter as well. So this is a list of all the commands in the Metapreter. I'll again, you can get this list using help or question mark. So I'll again highlight some of those, which is help, then info is there, then migrate is there, which tells that you can actually migrate your Metapreter code to some stable process. Let's browse through this. So there is get PID, which will get the current process identifier in which this Metapreter is actually attached. Then there is execute command. This shell will actually open that Windows shell in for us. And also there is one command PS, which will list all those processes in running in that Windows system. So this is the PS, which will list the running process in the Windows system. So we'll use that. These all are the processes running in that targeted system. So we can see that Windows processes are listed here. So indeed we are in that system. So we'll use get PID to get the process identifier, which is 988. So we can search that this 988 is actually attached to SVC host. But there is one thing, I mean this SVC host is not very stable process, and it randomly changes into some other process. So it might be possible that this Metapreter code gets out of this. So to quickly migrate this Metapreter to some stable process, we'll use migrate, and we can migrate it to a process explorer.exe, which is quite stable and which always runs in the Windows system. So we'll migrate this. And this migration is from 988 to 1420 PID, so which is successful. So now the Metapreter code is running in 1420, that is inside the explorer.exe. So now we'll use command shell, which will actually open a Windows shell. So here is the Windows shell, which you must be familiar with. Once we are into that system, we can use all those commands which we can use in Windows command prompt, like dir, it will list all the directories. For this demo, I have created one secret information file in this in my Windows XP. So that is present in C with the name secretinfo.txt. And let's say this contains a password, with a password @123 of some application. So let's try to get this file from this Ubuntu Metasploit. So we'll go into the C prompt, and then there is the file secretinfo.txt. So once we are sure that we have that secretinfo.txt, we'll exit from Metapreter and we'll use a command download, which will download the file from that operating system to our machine. So this is the secretinfo.txt, and we are downloading it in our home folder. So this download is successful, and now we can actually see whether this is in our system or not. So we'll just go in the home folder, and there is the file secretinfo.txt. So when we'll open it, will be the, it will have the same contents as the previous, which is saw in this Windows XP. So this is the, this contains the password. So in this way you can actually exploit any system which has this vulnerability, and it will actually give the information, give any secret information on that system. Now there is one more important thing, any thing we try to do in Windows system, this will be logged in events management. So Windows event management will log all the relevant information, but that happens, that doesn't happen in almost all operating system. So this is an event viewer. So in event viewer there are three things: application, security and system. So currently this security tab has some of the logs that this system has tried to, that some other processes tried to enter that system, because we have not done any other thing in the XP. So this must be some vulnerable thing. So metaprotector is a great command which will try to delete all the events from that Windows operating system, so that no one can actually know that it has been exploited. So that command is clear EV. So this will wipe all the records from the Windows system. So it is saying that it has wiped 6 records from security. So we can see that now when we refresh this, all the events have been wiped. So that means there is no information that this system has been attacked, but it has actually. So this ends our tutorial on Metasploit. Thank you.